since transferring from Sacred Heart University of getting guys in their spots.
And a turnover forced early by the Blue Jay defense. Here comes Ty-Shon Alexander. I'm here for Seton Hall with Miles Powell on the bench with two fouls and still 10.5 to play in this first half. Alexander will try the three. And the rebound.
Blocked so many shots and changed so many shots. You've got to give him a touch on the offensive end or at least help him be involved.
In the corner, Alexander. And when the threes start, Jays would love to get it running, but Seton Hall's controlled the pace in this first half. Alexander off the spin. And the rebound to Tyrese Samuel. Rattles around. It won't make a highlight, but it counts as two just the same. Extra pass. Alexander left alone. And Seton Hall.
Obviously, he's worked on it. But you're not going to live with that. If you're Creighton, you'll live with it. Not Seton Hall.
Alexander hoping he was going to get pulled
straight back.
Bishop off the fake. Finds Alexander. And that three won't go. Ty-Shon Alexander.
He's got to be smart, obviously, not to pick up the third foul. But I would guess that he's going to be playing this game a little bit, this half, a little differently than he started the game.
Oh, how about Jeffrey?
His ability to score the ball from anywhere on the floor.
Nine for Powell. Alexander, one step beyond the logo, lobbing it inside the Bishop, who can't connect at the rim. Popping free from behind the arc and then lost the handle on it. Diving on the floor is Bishop, and he tips it ahead to Alexander. Alexander running to the other side to tie the game up at 34.
It's got out of the way, forced him into an off-balance shot.
Alexander steps back for the three.
Look at that. Seton Hall team that can hurt you.
Gill on the bench with those four fouls. Alexander off the inbound, the three. Karam's wildly off. And the rebound by Ty-Shon Alexander. Jays by five. Jays by seven.
But I would call that a quick hitter. And Seton Hall's going to have to figure out how to get more of those quick hitters.
Alexander got an open look on the drive from Zegarowski, and Gill back on
the best thing for Seton Hall down the stretch. They're going to have to play faster.
6 of 12 from the floor is Powell. Alexander around the screen. Ty-Shon Alexander.
About 80 points a game. I never thought they'd get close to that after this game being tied at 32 at halftime. I look up and...
Oh, my! Ty-Shon Alexander.
Last time these two teams played, obviously St. John's took a loss by 12.
Back door. Alexander lays it in.
But they did a pretty good job.
Jones.
To Alexander. Step back from 10 feet. No. Rebound Jones. The follow. Pull up. No good. Alexander the board. Here comes Creighton. He'll pull up from three. Too strong. Sears the...
There's just something about playing here for St. John's. Maybe it's the close confines that have an adverse impact on the opponents and more assertiveness on the offensive end.
And he comes up with a steal. Took it right away. And he'll pull up for three. Money. They say foot on the line. It's a two.
How good was February for Creighton? They work it around. Alexander short on that three. And it will stay. Inside to Alexander. Size matchup turns. Left it short.
Stranger things have happened.
Yeah, Creighton was in the preseason poll.
Nice.
Picked to finish seventh. Ty-Shon Alexander goes back door and dunks it home. Ballack. Alexander from the corner. That one in and out.
And that's back door.
Alexander from the corners. Swish.
Menez is a terrific offensive rebounder. He's been on the bench because of foul trouble.
Alexander shot blocked by Figueroa. Open. Alexander. Ball fake and he'll pull up. Here's Jefferson going high to go. Again, Zegarowski on the bench with the three fouls. Alexander, too strong.
Verity.
Career high for Greg Williams. He's got 12, all from three. Alexander, and it rolls out.
I like the job that St. John's is doing. They challenge everything.
That three way off by Alex. Alexander from distance and knocks it down.
Jones with the screen for Zagorowski. Now Ty-Shon Alexander. His three just off the edge of the rim, and Brahoni tipped away. Good defense by Butler. Spins it around Alexander. Reverse on the baseline. Not going to go. And Tucker, two for Butler. And usually when Kamar Baldwin goes out, they like to play through Inzi. And he's not on the floor right now. Big offensive on the defense to the three-point line. Zagorowski into the corner. The three for Ty-Shon Alexander. Alexander was quiet in the first half. Just 3 points. Tough fadeaway. A little strong. Rebound. Can't get it from point-blank range. Jones the rebound. Where's Zagorowski? Ballack in the corner to Alexander. He'll hit the three. He knew it was good. For Ty-Shon Alexander and the Blue Jays. Bishop. Alexander hoists the three and hits the three.
And Butler's, you got to keep on competing here. This is a proud program that this hasn't happened to them very often as Alexander gets another one to go.
Sakar and him off the mark. And it's Ballack that comes away with a rebound. Good pass up ahead. Alexander right in motion. Lays it in for the first bucket. Annam has it swatted at the rim by Bishop. Alexander, stop and pop. Down to John.
Excellent.
Mahoney. Cut off in the mid post. Here's Ty-Shon Alexander taking it off the bounce. They say that's clean. Chase Johnson with a block. In the corner, Jamal Cain, no good. Look at the pace. Mitchell to Alexander to the bottom of the bucket. That's a two. His foot was on the line.
David Mitchell. Now they get Butler at home as well, and then Georgetown.
And one game back in the standings. Ty-Shon Alexander from 15 feet. Program record is another three off the mark for Marquette. Alexander only hit the backboard. He's a little slow
because of his leadership ability.
Zagorowski curling a pass round. That was beautiful, but off the side of the backboard, not so beautiful for that big body out there, you know?
That's right. And the quickness of the penetration. You see how that collapsed the defense that got Ty-Shon up.
Six in the first half. Scoring very balanced for Creighton, as it has been all year. They've got five guys that average double figures in Big East play. Alexander, tough shot. Look at that rebound.
Pound that here in the second half.
We have not had any flop warnings yet this ball game. Ty-Shon Alexander, good spin. Tough.
Oh, man. Well, you play off
Howard, 5 points, 2 of 8. Again, he averages over 27 a game. Alexander, left wing. Got it.
You talk about tough. Got an answer every time.
See what they go with here. Ty-Shon Alexander down the heart of the lane. Oh, he missed a bunny. Alexander patrolling the baseline. Now in the corner. Knocks it down. It's a three-pointer for Ty-Shon out. Simone missed and laid it in.
Well, that's great individual effort by Greg Elliott. You typically don't see that for three-point line.
But look at Creighton getting down there quickly, and the offense. Blue Jays running again. Good shot fake. Short with it, Alexander. One hand swing pass. Alexander. Tough shot. A good defense by Annam. Sakar Annam putting Creighton through the spin cycle. And another shot to silence the 8 points a game. Marquette 77.9. Alexander in rhythm. Theo John rebound. Alexander.
Wow.
I mean, it's deja vu. They've got this. Seven to shoot. He takes him off the bounce. Stops on a dime. Boy, almost traveled. Alexander's got to put it up. And a long rebound to Howard. Alex
Alexander has been the man tonight for the Blue Jays with 20 points. He's looking for more. What a tough shot by Ty-Shon Alexander.
And that's the energy Bishop brings.
Alexander, 5-on-4, fades back over the top of Paul Reed. On with Paul Reed in the post. Pass too hot for Ongenda. Ty-Shon Alexander knifes his way through.
I told you that Ballack, it wouldn't be long, even though you see the steal.
Showtime for Alexander. With the jumper in and out for Jalen Butts.
Coach McDermott talked about they have to get FGAs, get up as many shots as possible. And they're trying to get them up.
That's the old line, shooter's got to shoot, right?
Absolutely. This is my job. This is what I do. I do what I do.
Ty-Shon Alexander dials one up from the corner. Shot it. Jefferson to Ballack. Corner again. Two in a row for Ty-Shon Alexander. Over five a game. Top man of the conference is Charlie Moore. He's been handcuffed so far. Ty-Shon Alexander knew it right off of his fingertips. Well, he was here the last time that I was in town against Villanova. In transition again for Creighton. There's Alexander to the bucket. Chance for another. Ty-Shon. Nice ball movement. Ty-Shon Alexander. Nice backdoor feed again. Alexander and one. Chicago just a little bit too late for DePaul to get themselves back into it. Five to shoot. Alexander. 8 to 10 guys on that list.
No, no question. It's Sadiq Bey. Initially, he wasn't on my list at the beginning of the season, but got it going early. As you see.
And that right there, get it to the middle and try and kick opposite.
taking the ball. It was almost a 10-second violation, the time that they were taking to get that thing up, which was by design. And that's just patience.
Tough shot there. He's not scored in almost 3 minutes, but the Jays only with a 5-point lead. Alexander, the alley-oop to Bishop, and Mamu in there to break it up. He's one of those old guys you can win with, the senior. Ty-Shon Alexander blocked off, out to Mahoney. That three falls for Denzel. She's run down the floor in the first 10 seconds, try to create a break almost. Alexander, tough catch for Zegarowski. Now he'll shoot, and he hits.
He's got to understand there's some foul trouble. Got to attack.
Here's Alexander, seven to shoot. Mahoney with the open three. And
I know people talk about the NCAA tournament, but to have a banner up that says Big East Champions because it's a complete body of work over a long seat.
Ballack.
Beyond the arc.
St. John's doing what they do best. That's steal the basketball, third in the country at that. Zegarowski. Alexander, shot blocked by Figueroa. Here's Zegarowski for three. That's too strong. Bishop's in for Creighton. Good hustle play.
And that's demonstration of intensity.
Wow. And follows it.
He only shoots 19% from three, but nevertheless, in a game like this, everybody's a threat.
Mahoney.
St. John's has been the tougher, more intent team.
Here's Ballack. Misses.
Been increased from years past. With their offense, you don't need a ton of defense. Rolling to the rim. Kelvin Jones on the run. Off with that three. Rebound by Kelvin Jones. Second chance for Creighton. Zegarowski's three. Rebound for Kelvin Jones. Caleb Battle on the floor. The 6'5 freshman taking over for Kamar Baldwin. In the corner, Ballock's three is good. Alexander, the as he brings it up the floor, cross-court pass, Bishop to Alexander. Jefferson, that three won't go.
For Marquette.
111th game for Adam. He and Howard, the 2 4-year seniors, up top. And that's the guy who is a 5 seed right now, and Creighton is a 4. Catch and release three, Denzel Mahoney, and the
he's one of the best in the conference at doing so.
He doesn't need any space. Alexander just kind of flipped that up.
And Jones couldn't finish it.
The way that they put it on DePaul in the second half and then 18-3 run, that was something to see.
Inside, nice job evading the defender. Here's Mahoney dragging him away, taking the three, in and out. Baseline drive, he lost his footing. Crowd wanted to travel, didn't get the whistle, and now Mahoney left on his own island.
Wow.
Good look.
9 turnovers for Marquette, 5 for Creighton. Alexander down the right side of the lane. Good pass. Bishop flushes it. Blocked by Bailey. Mahoney gets it back and fumbled it out of bounds.
This Creighton team does an excellent job passing the ball, sharing it, and their guards do an excellent job rebounding.
Jefferson for three. Typical out of Jefferson looking for help. Zegarowski, the other corner. Frustration starting to build for a team trying to snap a 6-game losing streak. Alexander to Ballack. Another three. Ballack starting to heat up. 4 steals for Ty-Shon Alexander in this game.
He averages 2 steals a game.
Zegarowski fires away, and he buries his first. Nearly went in the hoop. Zegarowski transition. Ballack, corner three. Got another.
Man, not settling for the jump shot, being aggressive, showing the skill with the pump fake.
Let him fly by. Ballack missed.
Like they've got everything.
San Diego State getting the job done. Just slowly but surely taking out every opponent.
Including this Creighton Blue. Ballack pulls in the rebound. Transition. Zegarowski. What a start for out the basketball. Creighton does it as good as anybody. Zegarowski taps it out. Alexander. Alley-oop again. It's Jefferson.
Well, when you have a team that shares the ball, as you see another steal,
Alexander back up top to Bishop. Shot clock winding down, no reset. Alexander to Mitchell for three. It's all going right. Ty-Shon Alexander with 21 points today. It's a 13-3 run as Zegarowski tries to silence the
Creighton runs.
Alexander.
The ball. It was almost a 10-second violation. The time that they were taking to get that thing up, which was by design. And that's just patience.
Tough shot there.
For Marquette.
111th game for Adam. He and Howard, the 2 4-year seniors, up top. And that's the guy who likes it.
The way that they put it on DePaul in the second half, and then 18-3 run. That was tough to see.
Inside, nice job evading the defender. Baseline drive, he lost his footing. Crowd wanted to travel, didn't get the whistle, and now Mahoney left on his own island.
Wow.
done a great job since transferring from Sacred Heart University of getting guys in their spots.
And a turnover forced early by the Blue Jay defense. Here comes popping free from behind the arc and then lost the handle on it. Diving on the floor is Bishop, and he tips it ahead to Alexander. Alexander running to the other side.
In a preseason poll out of 10 teams, you'll have a chip on your shoulder.
Mamu Kelashvili has it picked away. Jays.
That's what Creighton needs. More assertiveness on the offensive
end. And he comes up with a steal. Took it right away. And he'll pull up for three.
Keep an eye on here this afternoon.
Tennessee working his way inside. A little bobble falls down. Scooped up by the Blue Jays.
2 points, two rebounds, and a lot more that isn't going to show up in that box score.
Battle. Tipped away, taken away. Another turnover for Butler.
And then the lob attempt. Finally, slow it down with Paul Reed in the post. Pass too hot for Ongenda. Ty-Shon Alexander.
I told you that Ballack, it wouldn't be long, even though he did. You see the steal?
That one came about 5 seconds into the shot clock.
They don't want to get in as you see. Ty-Shon Alexander has up.
And Paul Reed, shockingly, on the bench. He and Butts, a turnover this time, another one. That's a dozen. He's scoreless.
Hale, 13 on the shot clock for the Pirates. A handoff to Powell. Driving inside, pinned by Ty-Shon Alexander. McKnight looking, working to the rim. No, Roden soaring it. McKnight back out to Powell. Miles Powell with 8 to shoot against Ty-Shon Alexander. Got past Alexander to the rim, and he lays it in.
Great off. Does that when he has to find a teammate. He's been willing to do that as well.
Reynolds will turn the corner. The lob to Gill's tipped away. Mamu Kelash.
Call me Marshall, if that's what we're doing.
Donne Marshall.
Saying it wrong, both names.
Powell turning the corner. You could say Miles Powell, usually. Miles Powell. Oh, Alexander got a piece, able to dump it to Roden. Roden with the fake and the finish for either team today. 2:55 to go. How big was that Alexander three a moment ago as Powell leans in? No, Mamu Kelashvili's
in a preseason poll out of 10 teams, you'll have a chip on your shoulder.
Mamu Kelashvili has it picked away. Jays.
Misses the follow-up by Karaher. No, but Dunn grabs the board. Pull up. No good.
Powerful enough to get out there and play guys outside.
Five on the shot clock. Figueroa, the runner, short, and Bishop lost it out of bounds. And at that time, they knocked off seventh-ranked Tennessee. Figueroa, and it rolls.
10 on the shot clock. Kamar Baldwin going to try to go to work. Gets a screen from Enzi. From the elbow, jumper off the... Golden backs it out to Baldwin. 7 for Kamar Baldwin. Little floater is short. And the reef,
the pipe.
A great job out there. They ice him at the free throw line a little bit before. He still held it.
Little floater and a friendly bounce.
No.
Ballock with his 81st three-point make of the season as Howard can't get it to
cross. Strong with the basketball. Zagorowski got undressed and still was able to make the nice assist.
Marcus Howard can't get it.
Point difference.
McEwen. He is going to drive inside and lay it in.
It's talented and well put together from top to bottom with size, shooting, skill. I see those. I see the
fair.
Oh, I can see right now, like 15 bags of M&Ms in my backpack.
Coleman lands on the drive, finishes with the left hand.
Seconds remaining.
bounce back. That's what happens. Gill steps up. The miss, you're going to be wide open behind him.
And Powell off the screen, a little strong
teammate out. But Gill, I would say Quincy McKnight, he's got to go the other way.
And then Powell off the inbound. Got him. Well. Miles Powell off the inbound to Quincy McKnight. What do you expect from Seton Hall offensively? That from Powell. Oh, my goodness. What?
Back to Rutherford. Dunn open for three. Rolls in and out. Rutherford with eight on the shot clock. Figueroa off the screen.
Break the CMO transfer, double figures in 12 of the 16 games he's played in. Howard trying to get on track. Nope.
Gives up some height, but definitely strong enough to deal with fives in this league.
Howard trying to get on track, still cannot.
Watch Marquette here, the first possession. Try to free him up.
And they free him up. And there you go. Right on cue is. They're trying to do it with Howard. Well-designed play.
Momentum for this Blue Demons team before the half.
Hall got his man in the air. Missed the jumper. Jones. So far, Miles Powell is.
thinks his way through the game, patient.
Yeah, that's tough.
Offensive foul
back on the floor, and then Kevin Willard telling him, listen, you got to play the right way.
And that's an offensive foul on Shavar
Three, but that's when you put it on the floor. The defense is scrambling. You rip it through and get to the basket.
Powell steps around the screen. That three off.
Mommy Marshall, if that's what we're doing.
Donnay Marshall.
I'm saying it wrong, both names.
Powell turning the corner. You can say Miles Powell usually.
Figueroa with eight on the shot clock. Inside, Champagne goes up, and he will go to the line.
10 on the shot clock. Kamar Baldwin going to try to go to work. Gets a screen from Enzi. From the elbow, jumper off the...
Golden backs it out to Baldwin.
7 for Kamar Baldwin. Little floater is short. And the rebound.
Ballock with his 81st three-point make of the season as Howard can't get it to point difference. McEwen, he is going to drive inside and lay it in.
Staggered double first time.
Inside. Mama Kaylee's beating. Too strong.
Hand was down. If you're going to close out, you've got to get your hand up and take away a shot or at least contest the shot. Figueroa. St. John's comes in here and will be taking a loss to Creighton, but because Creighton is...
The only Blue Jays in double figures. Gillespie, pull up. Yes. And Colin.
Obviously, Alexander in the first half when he needed to. Zagorowski handling it. That's the story of the...
Here's his time, and Creighton has been incorrect. Ballet lock. Ballock. There you have it, Omaha. Here's Weems. Two-man game, Reed. Head trip, foul call.
These guys are X&O coaches. Nobody has learned more under better people than Patrick Ewing. It's really...
Finishes at the rim. Marshall steps through, left it short. Rebound.
Entire game. Gillespie driving, pulls up, knocks down a jumper. Now it's a three-point lead, 2 minutes.
That big win this year over Oregon that changed the face of the conference, certainly. Martin, little runner. White again. Second mark in the first half. This is a 12-3 run for Creighton. Great graphic popping out of our screen.
And look how Nebraska's, or Creighton's really trying to plug up the lane. They're really trying to make these driving lanes tough for Nebraska.
Oh, Sheena, brief pointer, but he's got 8 here today. Sheena drives, uncontested the layup from Damian.
He's 0 for 11. I talked to Greg McDermott about it. He's like, look, Damian's a very good shooter. He's not going to be a 40% three-point shooter. Better find Canfield in the corner.
13 minutes to assist last night. Knocks down a three. Chris Clark with a bunny inside.
Maybe you ride Mitchell. See what he can do here.
Flynn went right by him.
Oh.
What a weak side block by Ty-Shon out.
He preaches efficiency. And here's Junior Ballard. A little bit preparation.
A little show.
And a little go.
Pretty.
Danny Lewis with the basketball down the lane. Scores. He's actually led Creighton in three-point percentage in practice in their five-on-five scrimmages. So he can really shoot it. Is that saying
Soto? Con Sosa. La pide Sosa. Ahí está Sosa. Se levanta Sosa. El triple de Sosa. Canasta de Sosa. Agota el bote. Y ahí estamos de nuevo con Soto. Se la va a tener que jugar. Quedan 4 segundos. El lanzamiento de 3 de Soto. No entra. Milligan. Para adentro Milligan. Se filtra Milligan. Evita la mano de Grossell. Pero falla.
He wants the pick. Shot clock to 3. Hankins. Nice move and the jump call. They've been on fire since. 7 of their last 9. Had that altered by...
Under 3 minutes. 8 to shoot. Howard. Wide open window.
McClung wants the screen. Good hedge by Ballack. McClung has to fire up the 3. No, and a good box up.
He can make that, but that's not his strength. His strength is in the paint.
Gooden feeds Hankins. Goes George Gervin.
Wellage got the ball.
Got a piece of the ball. Lucky, that was, he's right at the rim.
In tight again, and there's Gooden. Fights.
And that's important because the top six get a bye to the quarterfinals of the Big East tournament.
Shot clock gets 10 for Jordan Tucker. McDermott sets the screen. Tucker the crossover. Step back for three. Comes up short. Badly. Gets his man up in the air.
Isaiah Roby not fouling. Been in foul trouble the last three games. Such a huge piece for Nebraska. Colquitt splits two defenders. The reverse not going to go. And fouled on the three again. This going on Ty-Shon Alexander. Hit home for James Palmer, who has a game-high 25.
This is the best that we've seen James Palmer here in a few games. Just such a mature.
Going to make them effective the way they play.
Right, and his versatility, he's what you call a glue guy because he does so many things for them.
LaMarcus Simon, former Creighton coach, former Oklahoma State coach. We actually used to practice going after loose balls and throwing them into the backcourt. As Jessup stepped at UC Riverside, they have two former St. Mary's assistants, Rick Croy and David Patrick, at the two Division I programs in Riverside.
Hobbit. Jay Jackson coming off 25 last time out. Underneath to Wesson, and Wesson with his first. They led by eight very early in this one. Woods. A shot, no. Rebound, Young, and a putback.
You really want.
And you know Creighton wants to get into a track meet. Seton Hall seems bound and determined not to let that happen. Wild shot that time. McKnight looking. Working to the rim, no. Roden soaring it. McKnight back out to Powell. Miles Powell with eight to shoot against Ty-Shon Alexander. Got past Alexander to the rim, and he lays it in.
Great off.
Misses the follow-up by Carraher. No, but Dunn grabs the board. Pull up. No good.
Powerful enough to get out there and play guys outside.
Five on the shot clock. Figueroa, the runner. Short, and Bishop lost it out of bounds.
Five to shoot. Baldwin step back two is good. Kamar
bounds as well. Howard is yet to get a shot up. You know that's going to change soon. In fact, it's going to change right here, but off the side of the iron.
Seconds remaining.
to step in. It gives you a chance as a coach to see who you can rely on and how long guys can go.
Powell gets it back. The extra pass to Mamu and the three fall.
You really want.
And you know Creighton wants to get into a track meet. Seton Hall seems bound and determined not to let that happen. Wild shot that time.
Three, but that's when you put it on the floor. The defense is scrambling. You rip it through and get to the basket.
Powell steps around the screen. That three off.
Mamu wants back. That's what happens. Gill steps up. The miss, you're going to be wide open behind him.
And Powell off the screen, a little strong. Well. Miles Powell off the inbound to Quincy McKnight. What do you expect from Seton Hall offensively? That from Powell. Oh, my goodness. What?
Back to Rutherford. Dunn open for three. Rolls in and out.
That's what happens when constant movement, particularly against rebounders.
Figueroa from the corner.
Just for the Butler bigs. Baldwin leaving for McDermott. His three up and down has just erased Butler's defense today.
Tucker, the three is off. The rebound
bounds as well. Howard is yet to get a shot up. You know that's going to change soon. In fact, it's going to change right here, but off the side of the iron.
It's a good job of on-ball defense.
Speaking of on-ball defense, Alexander disrupting Howard. Howard has to force it up. Break the Semo transfer double figures in 12 of the 16 games he's played in. Howard trying to get on track. Nope.
Gives up some height, but definitely strong enough to deal with fives in this league.
Howard trying to get on track, still cannot.
Watch Marquette here, the first possession. Try to free him up.
And they free him up. And there you go. Right on cue. They'll try to do it with Howard. Well-designed play.
Chicago. Get it to Moore, and quickly the double comes. And Jalen Coleman lands, fires away from three. Do it right off of his fingertips. It wasn't going in. Coleman lands from the wing.
If Malik would have made that three right there, I would have found a way to turn the lights out in this arena and let DePaul regroup.
Hale, 13 on the shot clock for the Pirates. The handoff to Powell. Driving inside, pinned by Ty-Shon Alexander.
What is it, $1 million he's given?
Yeah.
I got to get in.
He's got that.
I
got
to get in on that.
That's available. He was here the last time that I was in town against Villanova.
And was down.
On the road. They're unbeaten in Omaha, but 3-2 on the road this year. Alexander blocks.